Where are you going? Morning bell ain't rung yet. Get back to sleep.
Well, I want to beat the other fellas to the streets. Don't I want you to see I ain't been walking so good.
Oh, quit griping. You know how many guys fake a limp for sympathy? That bum leg of yours is a gold mine.
Well, someone gets the idea I can't make it on my own, they'll lock me in the refuge for good. Be a pal, Jack, and help me down. Whoa!
Careful! What, you want to bust your other leg too?
No, I want to go down.
You'll be down there soon enough. Taking a moment to drink in my penthouse, high above the stinking streets of New York.
You're crazy.
Why? Because I like a breath of fresh air? Because I like seeing the sky and the stars?
Oh, you're seeing stars, all right.
Them streets down there, they suck the life right out of my old man. Years of rotten jobs, stomped on by bosses. And when they finally broke him, they tossed him to the curb like yesterday's paper. Well, they ain't doing that to me.
But everyone wants to come here.
New York's fine for those who can afford a big, strong door to lock it out. But I tell you, Crutchy, there is a whole other way out there. So you keep your small life in the big city. Give me a big life in a small town. They say folks is dying to get here. Me, I'm dying to get away to a little town out west that's spanking new. And while I ain't never been there, I can see it's clear as day. If you want, I bet you could see it too. Close your eyes, come with me, where it's clean and green and pretty. And they went and made a city out of clay. Why, the minute that you get there, folks will walk right up and say, welcome home, son, welcome home to Santa Fe. Planting crops, splitting rails, swapping tails around the fire, except for Sunday when you lie around all day. Soon your friends are more like family, and they's begging you to stay. Ain't that neat, living sweet in Santa Fe?
You got folks there?
Got no folks nowhere. You?
Johnny, folks! I got friends.
Hey, how's about you come with me, huh? No one worries about no gimp leg in Santa Fe. You just hop a palomino, you'll ride in style.
Oh, feature me riding in style.
I bet a few months of clean air and you could toss that crutch for good. There's a life that's worth the living, and I'm gonna do my share. Work the land, chase the sun,
swim the whole Rio Grande just for fun. Watch me stand, watch me run.
Hey, don't you know that we's a family? Would I let you down? No way. Just hold on, kid, till that train makes Santa Fe. Time for dreaming's done, huh? Hey, Specs, Racer, Henry, Albert, Elmer, get a move on, boys. Them babes don't sell themselves.
Hey, Albert, Elmer, Specs, you heard Jack. Get a move on.
Dream. My lips still tingling.
Ho, 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 pretty girl.
A leg of lamb.
Ah. Hey, that's my cigar.
You'll steal another.
Hey, look, it's bath time at the zoo. I thought that I'd surprise my mother.
If you can find her.
Who asked you?
Tapes ain't moving like they used to. I need a new selling spot. Any ideas?
From Bottle Alley to the Harbor, the CC Pickens guarantee. Tiny bank up, bum, up, baba.
They almost all knows how to
just to get bad news.
Ain't it a fine life, carrying the banner through it all? A mighty fine life, carrying the banner top and tall. When that bell rings, we go to every wish is squeeze and spree and spishes, show up and splash and dishes. What a fine life, carrying the banner home free all.
Beautiful.
Hey, step aside, Romeo. Nothing more concerns you here. Morning, miss. Can I interest you in the latest news?
The paper isn't out yet.
I'd be delighted to deliver it to you, personally.
I have a headline for you. Cheeky boy gets nothing for his troubles.
Back to the bench, slugger. You struck out.
Oh, I'm crushed.
Hey, Crunchy, what's your leg say? Gonna rain?
And no rain. Partly cloudy, clear by evening.
We gotta bottle up this guy.
Yeah, and the limp sells 50 papes a week all by itself.
I don't need the limp to sell papes. I got personality. It takes a smile to spread like butter, the kind with turns a lady's head.
It takes an orphan with a stutter,
who's also blind and mute.
Summer stinks and winter's freezing when you work outdoors. Start up sweating, end up sneezing in between it pours. So it's a fine life, carrying the banner when you shine. A bunch of big shots, tossing out a freebie to the bar.
Waiting makes me antsy, I like living chancy.
I'll tell Nancy what a fine life, carrying the banner through the
blessed children. Love you, my dear, lost and depraved. Jesus loves you.
Thanks for the grub, sister.
Elmer, when are we gonna see you inside the church?
I don't know. It's bound to rain sooner or later.
Good old
Justice.
Cause it's two for a penny. If I take too many weasels, just makes me eat them after. Got a feeling about the headline. I supposed to be a headline page. So gonna sell it, we was giving them away. Best you dinner is a doozy. Got a pistol back in quizzy. That was how to make a newsy day. You wanna move the next edition? It was an earthquake or a war.
How about a crooked politician?
You hit with that.
Put it up the headline.
I hope it's real bloody with a nice clear picture.
The trolley strike? Not again.
3 weeks of the same story.
They're killing us with that snoozer.
Leg-way, step aside.
Dear me, what is that unpleasant aroma? I fear the sewers may have backed up during the night.
Or could it be
the Delancey brothers?
Hey, Oscar,
Word on the street is that you and your brother been taking money to beat up striking trolley workers.
So? It's honest work.
But cracking the heads of defenseless workers?
Take care of the guy who takes care of me.
Ain't your father one of the strikers?
Because he didn't take care of me.
Want some of that too, you lousy crip?
Hey, now that's not nice, Morris.
Hey, 5-1 Jack Skunksome.
One unfortunate day, you might find out you got a bum game of your own. How'd you like us picking on you, huh? Maybe we should find out.
I'll wait till I get my hands on you.
Oh, you gotta catch me first!
We'll be out there carrying the banner man to man. We're always out there soaking every sucker that we can. He's a headline, news, he's on a mission, kill the competition, sell an exhibition. We'll be out there carrying the banner, see us out there carrying the banner, always out there carrying the banner.
Newsies, line up.
Good morning, Weasel. Did you miss me?
The name is Wiesel.
Ain't that what I said? I'll take the usual.
100 papes for the wise guy.
Morning, Weasel.
At least call me Mister.
I'll call you sweetheart if you'd spot me 50 papes.
Drop the cash and move it along.
Whatever happened to romance?
100 papes for race. Next.
Good morning, Mr. Wiesel.
50 papes for Crutchy. Have a look at this. A new kid.
I pooped you.
Don't worry, kid. Rubs right off.
I'll take 20 newspapers, please.
20 for the new kid. All right, let's see the dime.
I'll pay you when I sell them.
Funny, kid. Cash up front.
But whatever I don't sell, you buy back, right?
Well, certainly. And every time you lose a tooth, I put a penny at your pillow. This kid's a riot. Come on, cough up the cash or move along. All right, Alva, let me see the money.
You know, Mr. Wiesel, you have a very, very interesting face. You ever think of getting into the moving pictures?
You think so, I could?
Sure, buy a ticket, they'll let anyone in.
Sorry, excuse me, I paid for 20 papers and I only got 19.
Do you see how nice I was to this new kid? And what did I get for my civility? Ungrounded accusations.
I just want what I paid for.
He said beat it.
Hey, no kid's right, Weasel. You gave him 19. Now, I'm sure it was an honest mistake on account of Oscar can't count to 20 with his shoes on.
Here, now take a hike.
Give him another 50 papes.
I don't want more papes.
What kind of news you don't want more papes?
I'm no charity case. I don't even know you.
His name's Jack.
Hey, this here is the famous Jack Kelly. He wants to skip jail off of the back or Teddy Roosevelt's carriage! Oh, he made all the papes.
How old are you, kid?
10, almost.
If anybody asks, you're 7. Younger sells more papes. And if we're gonna be partners...
Hold on, who said we were gonna be partners? Selling with Jack is a chance of a lifetime. You learn from him, you learn from the best.
Yeah, but if he's the best, then what's he want with me?
Because you got a little brother, and I don't. That puss could easily sell 1,000 papes a week. Look sad, kid. We're gonna make millions.
I'm Les. This is my brother, David.
Pleased to meet you, Davy. My two bits come off the top, then we split everything 70-30.
50-50. You wouldn't try to pull a fast one on a little kid.
60-40. And that's my final offer.
Deal.
Oh, that's disgusting.
It's just business. Nosies hit the streets. The sun is up, the headline stinks, and this kid ain't getting any younger.
Always out there, carrying the banner.
world is in trouble. Our circulation is down for the third quarter in a row.
But Mr. Pulitzer, every paper's circulation is down since the war ended.
Whoever said war was hell is not trying to sell newspapers.
We could use an exciting headline.
What have we got today?
The trolley strike.
That's not exciting. It's epic.
It's boring. Folks want to know, is the trolley coming up, ain't it? They don't care why.
And besides, Governor Roosevelt just put his support behind the workers.
That man's a socialist.
Teddy Roosevelt is no socialist. He's an American hero.
That man wanted out of football for being too violent. Football. Violent.
You're right.
He's not a socialist. He's a commie.
Mr. Pulitzer, please, you must have tried to sit still.
You're making Nunzio nervous. And when Nunzio gets nervous, I don't look pretty.
You never liked Roosevelt. You wrote an editorial against him day after day when he was running for governor. And guess what? He got elected.
How am I supposed to influence voters when they're not reading my opinion?
Big photos attract readers.
Do you know what big photos cost?
But without flashy photos or headlines, how are we supposed to sell more papers?
The answer's right before your eyes. You're just not thinking this through. Nunzio knows when he's cutting my hair. Trim a bit here, and then trim a bit there. Just a modest adjustment can fatten the bottom line.
Mr. Pulitzer, please.
Shaving is tricky, the razor should float. Shave me too close, and you may cut my throat. The simplest solution is that bolster the bottom line.
But how does that help us sell more papers?
We don't sell papers, silly. Newsies sell papers.
I've got it. Okay, right now, we charge the newsies 50 cents for 100 papers.
Yes.
But if we raise their price to 60 cents per 100...
Now you're getting somewhere.
A mere tenth of a penny per paper, and every single newsie would have to sell 25 more papers just to earn the same amount as always.
My thought exactly. It's genius.
It's gonna be awfully rough on those children.
Nonsense. I'll be giving them a real life lesson in economics. I couldn't offer them a better education if they were my own. Give me a week and I'll train them to be like an army that's marching through war. Proud of themselves and so grateful to me, they'll be begging to pay even more. When there's dirt on our shoes, boys, for God's sakes, relax. Why throw them out? All we need is some wax. Listen well to these barbershop lessons, for they'll see you through.
When we stop in the muck, you'll be fine.
The power of the press, yes, once again it's mine. The price of news goes up in the morning. Just a few common sense gents, that's the bottom line.
Evening paper, Mr. Paper.
Sing him to sleep, why don't you? Extra, extra, terrified flight from burning inferno. You heard the story right here. Hey, thanks, mister.
Okay, well, you just made that up.
I did not. I said he heard it right here, and he did.
My father taught us not to lie.
Yeah, and mine taught me not to starve.
Hey, I just sold my last paper.
I got one more.
Sell it to pay for it.
Keep it here. Buy a paper from a poor orphan boy?
Oh, you dear thing. Of course I'll take a paper. Here's a dime.
Born to the breed.
This is so much better than
school.
Don't
even think it. When Pop goes back to work, we go back to school.
So how's about we divvy up the money, grab some chow, and find you somewhere safe to spend the night?
We better be getting home. Our folks will be waiting dinner.
You got folks, huh?
Doesn't everyone?
Our pop's tangled with the delivery truck on the job. It messed his leg up real bad. That's how it comes we had to find work.
Yeah, sure, that makes sense. Sorry about your dad.
Say, why don't you come home with us for dinner? Our folks will be happy to have you.
Mom's a great cook.
Thank you for the invite, but I just remembered I got plans with a fella. He's probably waiting on me right now.
Is that the guy?
Kelly!
Run for it!
I need to grab him! Kelly, stop!
Slow down. We lost him.
Someone want to tell me why I'm running? I got no one chasing me. Who was that guy?
That was Snyder the Spider, a real sweetie. He runs a jail for underage kids called The Refuge. The more kids he locks up, the more money the city pays him. Only problem is, all that money goes straight into his own pocket. So do yourselves a favor and stay clear of him and The Refuge.
Hey, you over there, Sue. No kids allowed in the theater.
Oh, not even me, Miss Meta.
Jack Kelly, man of mystery, give me a hug. Where you been keeping yourself, kid?
Never far from you, Miss Meta. Boys, may I present Miss Meta Larkin, the greatest star on the Bowery today. She also owns the joint.
The only thing I own is the mortgage. Pleasure, gents.
A pleasure. What's wrong with you?
Are you blind? She got no clothes on.
That's her costume.
But I can see her legs.
Step out of his way so he can get a better look. Theater's not only entertaining, it's educational. Got the picture, kid?
Miss Meadow, we got a little situation out on the street. Mind if we hide out here a while?
We're better to escape trouble than a theater. Is Snyder after you again?
Hey, Jack. Did you really escape jail on the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage?
Come on, what would the governor be doing at a juvenile jail?
So happens he was running for office and wanted to show he cared about orphans and such. So while he got his mug in the paper, I got my butt in the back seat and off we rode together.
You really know the governor?
He don't, but I do. Say, Jack, when you've got time, I want you to paint me another one of these backdrops. The last one you did is a doozy. Folks love it, and the way things are going, I could actually pay.
You pictured that?
Your friend's quite an artist.
Okay, don't get carried away. It's a bunch of trees.
You're really good, though.
That boy's got natural aptitude.
Jeez, I never knew no one with aptitude.
Miss Meta, you're on.
Yeah? How am I doing? Boys, lock the door and stay all night. You're with Meta now!
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the star of our show, Miss Meta Larkin!
I'm doing all right for myself, folks. I'm healthy, I'm wealthy, I'm wise. My investments and such have all gone up so much. Seems whatever I touch starts to rise. I've got men, I've got money, and yet the thing I want most, I can't get. I live on a mansion in Long Island Sound. I pulled up a weed, they found oil in the ground. But you're telling me you don't want me around. Chilla and mink, and some give me diamonds as big as a sink, but you wouldn't give me so much as a wink. Now baby, that's rich. I get brandy from Andy and candy from Scott's, oh, and Frank and Eduardo chipped in a freight yacht. I get stares from the fellas and prayers from the Pope, but I run out my luck getting stuck with some dope. Oh, baby, I was just talking about you.
Now listen, sport, this life's too short to waste it on you. It may be rough, but soon enough, I'll learn to make do. Have a big hand for the Bowery Beauties!
Don't come a knocking on my door.
Well, hello again.
This is a private box.
Well, why not I should lock the door? Twice in one day, you think it's fate?
Go away. I'm working.
A working girl, huh? Doing what?
Reviewing the show for the New York Sun.
I work for the world.
And somewhere out there, someone else cares. Go tell them.
But the view's better here.
Please go away. I'm not in the habit of speaking with strangers.
Then you're gonna make one lousy reporter. The name's Jack Kelly.
Is that what it says on your rap sheet?
A smart girl, huh? Beautiful, smart, independent.
Do you mind?
I got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. Love at first sight's for suckers, at least it used to be. Look, girls are nice once or twice till I find someone new. But I never planned on someone like you. I got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. Love at first sight for suckers, at least it used to be.
What are you doing?
Quiet down, there's a show going on.
You are the most impossible boy.
Sirens kept me awake all night.
Fire sirens is like lullabies to me. The louder they wail, the better the headline. The better the headline, the better I eat. And the better I eat,
the further away from you I sleep.
Morning, everybody. Sorry we're late. We had to help our mother with something.
They got a mother. I was gonna get me one.
Well, what'd you do with the one you had?
He traded her for a box of cigars.
They was Coronas.
We have a father, too.
A mutter and a fodder?
Ain't we the hoi polloi?
So how's it going today?
Ask me after they put up the headline.
Here it comes now.
New newsy price. 60 cents per hundred.
Is that news?
It is to me.
They jacked up the price of papes. 10 cents more a hundred.
I can eat 2 days on a dime.
I'll be sleeping on the streets.
You already sleep on the streets.
Well, in a worse neighborhood.
Hey, what are y'all standing around for?
Get a load of this, Jack.
Like Pulitzer, don't make enough already.
Papes for the newsies.
Relax, it's gotta be a gag.
Line up, boys.
Good joke, Weasel. Really got the fellas going. I'll take 100 and be on my way.
100 costs 60.
I ain't paying no 60.
Then make way for someone who will.
You bet. Me and the fellas will take a hike on over to the Journal.
Yeah!
Hold on, I'll save you the walk. They up their prices too.
Then we'll take our business to the sun.
Yeah.
It's the same story around town. New day, new price.
Why the jack up?
For them to have the answers, you gotta be asking for up the food chain. So you better be buying or moving on.
Come here, fellas.
They can't just do that, can they?
Why not? It's their paper.
It's their world.
Ain't we got no rights?
We got the right to starve. Come on, let's get our pay to the streets while we still can.
At them prices?
We got a choice.
Hold on. No one is paying no new nothing.
You got an idea?
Relax. Let me think this through.
Well, what's your angle?
Stop crying him. Let the man work it out. Hey, Jack, you still thinking?
Sure he is. Can't you smell the smoke?
All right, here's the deal. If we don't sell papes, then no one sells papes. We don't go back to that window till they put the price back where it belongs.
But what, you mean like a strike?
You heard Davey, we're on strike.
Yeah. Oh,
what I didn't say.
We shut down this place just like them workers shut down the trolleys.
And the cops will bust their heads. Half of them strikers are laid up with broken bones.
Oh, cops ain't gonna care about a bunch of kids. Right, Davey?
Leave me out of this. I'm just here trying to feed my family.
Oh, what? And the rest of us is just on playtime? Just because we only make pennies, don't give no one the right to rub our noses in it.
It doesn't matter. You can't strike. You're not a union.
What if I says we is?
There's a lot of things you gotta have in order to be a union. Like membership.
What do you call these guys?
And officers?
I nominate Jack President!
Yeah!
Gee, I'm touched.
How about a statement of purpose?
Must have left it in my other pants.
What's a statement of purpose?
A reason for forming the union?
What reason did the trolley workers have?
I don't know. Work hours, wages, safety on the job.
Who don't need that? No, bet if your father had a union, you wouldn't be out here selling papes right now. Yeah?
Yeah.
So, our union is hereby formed to watch each other's backs. Union do we stand. Hey, that's not that bad. Somebody write that down.
I got a pencil.
Meet our Secretary of State.
Yeah.
If you want to strike, the membership's got to vote.
Then let's vote. Fellas, what do you say? The choice is yours. Do we roll over and let Pulitzer pick our pockets? Or do we strike?
Strike!
You heard the voice of the membership. The Newsies of Lower Manhattan are officially on strike. What next?
Wouldn't a strike be more effective if someone in charge knew about it?
It would be a pleasure to tell Weasel myself.
Yeah, and who tells Pulitzer? Davey?
I don't know. I guess you do, Mr. President?
That's right, we do. And what do we tell them?
The newspaper owners, they need to respect our rights as employees.
Yeah, Pulitzer and Hearst gotta respect the rights of the working kids of this city.
They can't just change the rules when they feel like
it. Yeah, we do the work, so we get a say.
We've got a union!
Yeah!
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think we're nothing. Are we nothing?
No!
They need to understand that we're not enslaved to them. We're free agents.
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think they got us. Do they got us?
No!
We're a union now. The Newsboys Union. And we mean business.
Even though we ain't got hats or badges, we're a union just by saying so.
And the world will know.
What's supposed to stop some other guys from coming along and selling our papers?
Just let them try. No, we can't beat up on other kids. We're all in this together.
What's it gonna take to stop the wagons? Are we ready?
Yeah!
What's it gonna take to stop the scalpers? Can we do it?
Yeah!
We'll do what we gotta do until we break the will of mighty Bill and Joe.
And the world will know, and the journal too. Mr. Hearst and Pulitzer, have we got news for you? See, the world don't know when they're gonna pay. Instead of hawking headlines, we'll be making them today. Yeah! And our ranks will grow.
And we'll kick their ear.
Yeah! And the world will know that we've been here.
When the circulation bell starts ringing, will we hear it?
No!
What if the delanges call out swinging? Will we hear it?
No! 100 voices singing. Who can hear a lousy whistle blow? And the world will know that this ain't no game. That we got a ton of rotten fruit and perfect Dane. So they gave their word, well it ain't worth beans. Now you're gonna see what stop the presses really means. And the old will weep and go back to sleep. And we got no choice but to see it through.
A seltzer.
Over here.
That'll be 2 cents, please.
2 cents for a glass of seltzer? Just give me a water.
How did I ever see that one coming?
I'd say we launched our strike in the most auspicious manner. Yeah? No?
I don't know about that, but we should scare the bejeebus out of Weasel!
Yeah! Did you see that the Lancies didn't know which way was up?
Yeah!
So, Davey, what's next?
Spread the word. Let all the working kids know about the strike.
All right, you heard the man. Let's split up and spread the news.
I'll take Harlem.
I got Midtown.
I got the Bronx.
And I got the Bowery.
Specs, you take Queens. Tommy Boy, you take East Side. And who wants Brooklyn? Come on. Brooklyn! Spot Collins territory? Finch, you telling me you scared of Brooklyn?
I ain't scared of no turf. But that Spot Collins gets me a little jittery.
Me and Dave, you'll take Brooklyn.
Me? Hold on. Me and Les, we're going home and we're gonna go football.
Why is everyone so scared of Brooklyn?
What are you doing here?
Asking a question. Do you have an answer?
Brooklyn is the sixth largest city in the entire world. You got Brooklyn, you hit the muddleload. You know, for someone who works for the New York Sun, you sure do spend an awful lot of time hanging around at the world. So what's that about, huh? What, you following me?
The only thing I'm following is a story. A ragtag group of ragamuffins want to take on the cake makers of New York. Think you got a chance?
Hey, shouldn't you be at the ballet?
Question too difficult? I'll rephrase. Will the richest and most powerful men in all of New York give the time of day to a gang of kids who haven't got a nickel to their name?
Hey. You don't gotta be insulting. I've got a nickel.
So I guess you could say you're a gang of kids, like David's, looking to go up against Goliath?
Oh, we never said that.
You didn't have to. I did.
You know, I've seen a lot of papes in my time, and I ain't never noted no girl reporters writing hard news.
Wake up to the new world. Game's changing. How about an exclusive interview?
Ain't your beat entertainment?
This is entertaining. So far.
What's the last news story you wrote?
What's the last strike you organized?
Step aside, Kelly. Mies thinks the lady needs to be handled by a real man.
You think's wrong, Romeo.
She knows my name.
I'd say we save any exclusive for a real reporter.
Do you see anyone else giving you the time of day? Okay, so I'm just busting out of the social pages, but you give me the interview and I promise I'll get you the space.
You really think we can make the papers?
Take on a paper like the world and you'll make the front page.
You want a story? Be in front of the circulation gates tomorrow morning and you'll get one. Oh, and bring a camera. You're gonna want to snap a picture of this.
Yeah. Let's go, boys! I got paying customers that need these tables. I'm setting up for dinner. Come on.
Come on, boys. We got newsies to visit.
They won't be soon. That's all. We get
out. Yeah, sure.
And the world will know we can keep it score. Even they give us all rights, so we get to have more. We've been down too long.
So what's your story? You selling papes to pay for art school?
Art school? What, you kidding me?
You've got real talent. You should be inside the paper, not outside hawking it.
Maybe that ain't what I want.
Then tell me what you do want.
Can't you see it in my eyes?
Have you always been their leader?
I'm a blowhard. Davey's the brains.
Modesty is not a trait I would have pinned on you.
You got a name?
Catherine Plummer.
What's the matter, ain't you sure?
It's my byline, the name I write under. So, tell me about tomorrow. What are you hoping for?
I'd rather tell you about what I'm hoping for tonight.
Mr. Kelly.
Today we stopped our newsies from carrying out papes, but the wagons still delivered to the rest of the city. Tomorrow, we stop the wagons.
Are you scared?
Do I look scared? But ask me again in the morning.
Good answer. Good night, Mr. Kelly.
Oh, come on. Where are you running off to? It ain't even dinner time.
I'll see you in the morning. And, off the record, good luck.
Hey, Plummer. Write it good. We both got a lot riding on you.
You heard the man. Write it good. Write it good or it's back to wheezing your way through the flower show. No pressure. Let's go. Newsies stop the world. A little hyperbole never hurt anyone. With all eyes fixed on the trolley strike, there's another battle brewing in the city. And if I could just write about it. Come on, Catherine, those boys are counting on you. Oh, you poor boys. Write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is big, lady, don't screw it up. this is not some little vaudeville I'm reviewing. Poor little kids versus rich, greedy, sour pusses. Ah! It's a cinch! It could practically write itself, and let's pray it does. Because as I may have mentioned, I have no clue what I'm doing. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Will that, plus the screaming of 10 angry editors? A girl is a girl! How the hell is that even legal? Look, just go and get her. Not only that, there's a story behind the story. Thousands of children exploited, invisible. Speak up, take a stand, and there's someone to write about it. That's how things get better. Give life's little guy some ink, and when it dries, watch what happens. Those kids will live and breathe right on the page, and once they're center stage, watch what happens. And who's there with her camera and her pen? As boys turn into men, they'll storm the gates. And then just watch what happens when they do. A modern-day David is posed to take on the rich and powerful Goliath. With swagger of one twice his age and a few nuggets of truth, Jack Kelly stands ready to face the behemoth Pulitzer. Now that's how you turn a boy into a legend. Picture a handsome, heroically charismatic, plain-spoken, no-nothing, skirt-chasing, cocky little son of a... Lie down with dogs and you wake up with a raise and a promotion. So he's a flirt. Complete egomaniac. The fact is, he's also the face of the strike. What a face. Face the fact, that's a face that could save us all from sinking in the ocean. Like someone said, power tends to corrupt an absolute power. Wait, corrupts? Absolutely, that is genius! Give me some time, I'm twice as good as that. 6 months from never, just look around at the world we're inheriting and think of the one we'll create. Their mistake is they got old, that is not a mistake we'll be making. No, sir, we'll stay young forever. Give those kids and me the brand new century. Watch what happens. It's David and Goliath, do or die. The fight is on and I can't watch what happens. But all I know is nothing happens if you just give in. It can't be any worse than how it's been. And it just so happens that we just might win. So whatever happens, let's begin.
Anyone else coming?
Don't got a clue.
You seen Spot Collin, right? What'd he say?
Sure, we seen him.
Him and about 20 of his gang.
Them Brooklyn boys is big.
And I gotta say, Spot was very impressed, wasn't he?
I'd say.
So, they're with us.
That depends on how you look at it. If you look and see Brooklyn, yeah, they're with us.
They wanted proof that we're not gonna fold at the first sign of trouble.
Are we?
We are not. There's us and Harlem.
Hold on, boss. Harlem wants to know what Brooklyn's gonna do.
How about Queens?
Queens will be right there back in a sec.
You see?
As soon as they get the nod from Brooklyn.
Yeah, I got this same fisheye in Midtown.
Say, Oscar, looks like we got bum information about a strike happening here today. Now, I'm not complaining. My scopus and arm could use a day's rest.
Are we doing the right thing?
Sure we are.
Maybe we put this off a couple of days.
No. We can't put this off. Tell them, if we put this off, they'll never take us seriously again.
Fellas, we can't back down now. No matter who does or doesn't show. Like it or not, now is when we take a stand.
How's about we just don't show up for work? Won't that send a message?
They'll just replace us. They need to see us stand our ground. Davey, Tell them.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you'll win it. We will find a way. But let us seize the day.
Hey, Jack, look what I made. Good, huh? Strike!
That's great!
It's pitiful.
Don't be so quick to judge. Maybe Pulitzer will see it outside of his window and feel sorry for us.
Hey, Specs, any sign of reinforcements? Davey?
Courage cannot erase our fear. Courage is when we face our fear. Tell those with power, safe in their tower, we will not obey. Behold the brave battalion that stands side by side, too few in number and too proud to hide. Then say to the others who did not follow, you're still our brothers, and we will fight for you.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Once we've begun, if we stand as one, someday become somehow.
Singing. Beautiful day to crack some heads, ain't it? Step right up and get your papes.
Are you working or trespassing? What's your pleasure?
Who are they?
Scouts, who do you think?
If they think they can come in here and take our job,
we can handle them. Let's soak them, boys!
Wait, no, wait! We all stand together or we don't have a chance. Jack.
Right, I know. I hear you. Listen, fellas. I know somebody puts us up to this. And probably pays you some extra money, too. Yeah? Well, it ain't right. Pulitzer thinks that we are gutter rats with no respect for nothing, including each other. Is that who we are? Well, we stab each other in the back. And yeah, it's who we are. But if we stand together, we change the whole game. And it ain't just about us. All across the city, there are boys and girls who ought to be out playing or going to school. Instead, they're slaving to support themselves and their folks. Listen, ain't no crime to being poor. And not a one of us complains if the work we do is hard. All we ask is a square deal. Fellas, for the sake of all the kids in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in this city, I beg you, throw down your papers. And join the strike.
Please.
I'm with you.
Yeah.
Now is the time to seize the day.
Now is the time to seize the day.
Answer the call and don't delay.
Answer the call and don't delay. Wrongs will be righted. If we're united, let us seize the day.
You're kidding, right? At the end of the day, who are you gonna trust? Them or them?
Yeah!
Now we're hearing loud and clear.
Now we're hearing loud and clear.
Like it or not, we're drawing near.
Like it or not, we're drawing near. Proud and defiant, we'll slay the giant. Judgment Day is here.
What the hell? My father's gonna kill me anyway.
Yeah! Hostage of Harlem, look what's begun. One for all and all for one. Strike, 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 strike. Oh.
folks, we finally got a headline. Nosey's crushed as balls attack. Crutchy's calling the dumb crips just too damn slow. Guys are fighting, bleeding, falling, thanks to good old Captain Jack. Captain Jack just wants to close his eyes and go! Let me go far away, somewhere they will never find me, and tomorrow won't remind me of today. When the city's finally sleeping and the moon looks old and gray, I get on a train that's bound for Santa Fe. And I'm gone, and I'm done. No more running, no more lying, no more fat old men denying me my pay. Just the moon saw big and yellow, it turns night right into day. Dreams come true, yeah they do, in Santa Fe. Where does it say you've gotta live and die here? Where does it say a guy can't catch a break? Why should you only take what you're given? Why should you spend your whole life living trapped where there ain't no future? Even at 17, breaking your back for someone else's sake. If the life don't seem to suit ya, how about a change of scene? Far from the lousy headlines and the deadlines in between. Santa Fe, my old friend, I can't spend my whole life dreaming, though I know that's all I seem inclined to do. I ain't getting any younger, and I wanna start brand new. I need space and fresh air. Let them laugh in my face. I don't care. Stay in my place. I'll be there. Just be real is all I'm asking. Not some painting in my head, 'cause I'm dead if I can't count on you today. I got nothing if I ain't got Santa Fe.
Don't say I never give you nothing. And before you say water's nothing, well, just ask a fish.
In the desert.
Why do old people have to talk?
To prove they still alive?
Good morning, gentlemen. Oh, did you get a look of these glum mugs? Could these really be the same boys that made the front page of the New York Sun?
The front page of what?
Let me see. Look at that. Look at, that's me. Front page and you ain't even dead.
Where's me?
Wait till my old man gets a load of this. I won't be last in line for the talk tonight.
Sure. You got us in the paper?
You got yourselves in the paper.
Newsies stopped the world. Now there's a headline even Elmo could sell.
What else do you got?
Mine's the only story that ran. Pulitzer declared a blackout on all strike news, so even I'm shut down now. I heard they arrested Crutchy. Did they get Jack too?
The Delanceys just spreading the story that he took it on the lamb.
for a set of caps.
Jack don't run from no fight.
Take it down, shortstop. I'm just reporting the news.
For jumping Jack's sake, could you guys stow the curiosity long enough to drink in the moment?
I'm famous.
What of it?
Are you stupid or what? When you're famous, the whale is your erster.
Your what?
Your erster. Your erster. The fancy clam with a pearl inside.
Oh, oyster. How much does being famous pay?
You don't need money when you're famous. They give you whatever you want. Gratis.
A pair?
Apartment and box at the Sheephead races.
Pastrami on rye with sour pickle.
My personal bus on a wooden nickel.
Look at me, I'm the king of New York. Suddenly, I'm respectable. Stare right at you, lousy with stature.
Nothing with all the buckety bucks. I'm blowing my dough and going deluxe.
And there I be, ain't I pretty? My city, I'm the king of New York.
My very own bed in my grill. A barbershop haircut that costs a quarter.
Regular beat for the star reporter.
Camp's great punk, she's the king of New York.
I'm the king of New York.
We were sunk, pale and pitiful.
Bunch of wet noodles,
posers, poodles.
Us out
they
drown us in ink.
So let's get drunk.
Yeah.
Dodge with liquor. Pain works quicker when you're king.
I gotta be either dead or dreaming. Cause look at that paint with my face beaming. Tomorrow they may wrap fishes singing. But I gotta stop for one whole minute.
Dear Jack, greetings from the refuge.
How are you? I'm okay. Guess I wasn't much help yesterday. Snyder soaked me real good with my crutch.
Oh yeah, Jack, this is crutchy by the way.
These here gods, day is rude. They say jump or you jump or you're screwed. But the food ain't so badly so far, 'cause so far they ain't brought us no food. I miss the rooftop, sleeping right out in the open, in your penthouse in the sky. There's a cool breeze blowing even in July. Anyway, and so guess what? There's a secret escape plan I got. Tie a sheet to the bed, toss the end out the window, climb down then take off like a shot. Maybe though, not tonight. I ain't slept and my leg still ain't right. Hey, but poet saw he's going down, and then Jack, I was thinking we might just go. Like he's saying, where it's clean and neat and pretty, with no buildings in your way. And he's riding Palominos every day. Once that train makes... I hate this place. I'll be fine and good as new. But there's one thing I need you to do. On the rooftop you said that a family looks out for each other. So you'll tell all the fellas for me to protect one another. The end. Your friend. Your best friend. Your brother. Crudgy.
Piped out!
Here's everything I owe you for the first backdrop, plus this one, and even a little something extra just accounting because I'ma miss you so.
Miss Meta.
Jack.
You're a gem.
Just tell me you're going somewhere, not running away.
Does it matter?
If you go somewhere and it turns out not to be the right place, you can always go somewhere else. But if you're just running away, nowhere's ever gonna be the right place.
How's about letting a pal know you're alive?
I'll leave you with your friends.
Where'd you go? We couldn't find you.
Ever think I didn't want to be found?
Is that a real place? That Santa Fe? Did you see the paper? For front page news above the fold. Oh, yes. Above the fold.
Good for you.
Come on. Everyone wants to meet the famous Jack Kelly. Even Spot Collins sent a kid just to say next event, Brooklyn's in. How about that?
We got stomped into the ground.
Yeah, they took round one. I'll grant you that. But with press like this, a fight is far from over.
Every newsie who could walk showed up this morning to sell papes like the strike never even happened.
And I was there with them. If I don't sell papes, my folks don't eat.
You know, save your breath. I get it. It's hopeless.
But then I saw this look on Weasel's face. He was actually nervous. Then I realized, this is far from over. We got him worried. Really worried. And I walked away. And lots of other kids did too. And that's what I like to call a beginning.
There he is, just like I said.
For crying out loud, where's a fella gotta go to get away from you people?
Oh, there's no escaping us, pal. We're inevitable.
So what's the story? Can we have the theater?
Pipe down, I didn't ask yet.
What's the holdup? I need to let my girl know. We've got a date.
Your girl?
You heard me. I've been swatting scripts away all morning. Fame is one intoxicating potion. And here's this girl, Sally. She's a plum.
Word is you wrote a great story.
You look like hell.
Hey, Jack. Where's that supposed to be?
It's Santa Fe.
I gotta say, Jack, this go west young man routine is getting old.
Even Horace Greeley moved back to New York.
Yes, he did. And then he died.
You know, ain't reporters supposed to be nonpartisan?
Ask a reporter. Pulitzer's had me blacklisted from every news desk in town.
Can we table the palaver and get back to business? Will Meta let us have the theater or not?
That's what I've been trying to tell you. We want to hold a citywide rally where every newsie gets a say and a vote. And we do it after work hours so no one loses a day's pay. Smart?
Smart enough to get you committed to a padded room.
The guy who paints places he's never seen is calling us crazy.
What, you want to see a place I've seen? How about this? Nosy Square, thanks to my big mouth, flowed to overfilling with failure. Kids' hearts and others arrested.
Lighten up. No one died.
Is that what you're aiming for? Go on and call me a coward. Call me a quitter. No way I am putting them kids back in danger.
We're doing something that's never been done before. How could that not be dangerous?
Yeah, Speck sprung me a note from Crutchy at the refuge. I tried to see him. I climbed the fire escape. But they busted him up so bad he couldn't even come to the window. Now what if you don't make it? What, you willing to shoulder that for a tenth of a penny of
pay? It's not about pennies. You said it yourself. If my father would have had a union, we wouldn't be in the mess we're in.
If I wanted a sermon, I'd show up for church.
Tell me how quitting does Crutchy any good. Exactly. So, here's how it goes once we win. And we will be winning, make no mistake.
We'll be what?
We're already winning.
Right.
And we'll tell them straight out, they let Crutchy go all day. Keep getting pounded.
Dave, what the hell? Did they bust up your brains or something? As I recall, Dave, we all got our asses kicked. They won.
Won the battle.
Oh, come on.
Jackie, think about it. We've got them surrounded.
Here's what I think. Judge a jerk. He's a rattlesnake.
You're right. And you know why a snake starts to rattle.
No, why?
Because he's scared.
Sure.
Go and look it up. The poor guy's head is spinning. Why would he send for the goons? An entire army, dozens of goons, plus the cops.
You know, you may be right.
Thank you, God.
If he wasn't afraid.
Exactly.
He knows we're winning. Get those kids to see we're circling victory. And watch what happens. We're doing something no one's even tried. And yes, we're terrified. But watch what happens. Dumpty is about to crack.
We've got space,
we've got the plan,
and we've got gas.
So just watch what happens. We're back.
And I've got a date.
Pulitzer, how can you express so much sympathy for the trolley workers and yet have none for your own newsies?
Because the trolley workers are striking for a fair contract.
The newsies are striking against me.
I would spare you this embarrassment if I could, but that theater, it's private property.
He can't order a raid without legal cause.
Mr. Mayor, would the fact that this rally is being organized by an escaped convict be enough to shut it down?
An escaped convict?
A fugitive from one of your own institutions. A convicted thief wreaking mischief on our law-abiding community. Mr. Snyder, which one did he say he was again?
That one there.
And how do
Jack
you know
Kelly.
How do you know this boy?
His is not a pleasant story. He was first sentenced to my refuge for loitering and vagrancy. But his total disregard for authority so made him a frequent visitor.
And you called him an escaped thief?
After his release, I caught him myself, red-handed, trafficking stolen food and clothing. He was last sentenced to 6 months, but the willful ruffian escaped.
So he'd be doing the city a service by removing this criminal from our streets.
In that case, we'll just take him in quietly and...
What good will the quiet do me? I want a public example made out of him.
Mr. Pulitzer!
here?
Right outside the door. He's asked to see you.
Ask and you shall receive. Mr. Snyder, do as you please. Sit.
Mr. Jack Kelly.
Afternoon, folks.
And which Jack Kelly is this? The charismatic union organizer or the petty thief and escaped convict?
Which one gives us more in common?
Impudence is a bad taste when crawling for mercy.
Crawling? Now that's a laugh. See, I just dropped by with an invite. Seems a few hundred of your employees are rallying to discuss some recent disagreements. Now I thought it only fair to invite you to state your case straight to the fellas. So what do you say, Joe? One I should save your spot on the bill?
You are as shameful of a creature as I was told. What I was doing when I was your age, boy, I was fighting a war.
Yeah? And how'd that turn out for you?
It taught me a lesson that shaped my life. War isn't won on the battlefield. It's the headline that crowns the victor.
I'll keep that in mind when New York wakes up to front page photos of our rally.
Rally till the cows come home. Not a single newspaper will publish a word. And if it's not in the newspaper, it never happened.
You may run this city, but there are some of us who cannot be bullied. Even some reporters.
Such as that young woman that made you yesterday's news. Talented girl, and quite beautiful as well, don't you think?
I'll tell her you said so.
No need. She can hear for herself. Can't you, Catherine? Yes, my daughter. You may be asking why the nom de plume and why my daughter doesn't work for me. Good question. I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure, but instead she decided to pursue a career. She was showing real promise until the recent lapse. But you're done with that for now, aren't you, Catherine?
Jack, I...
Don't trouble the boy. He has a plate full of his own. Wouldn't you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Hello, Jack.
Ooh, does anyone else feel a noose tightening? Well, let me tell you an alternative scenario. You attend this rally and speak against this hopeless strike and see that your criminal record expunged and enough cash in your pockets to get you in a first-class train compartment from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say he wanted to travel west, didn't you?
There ain't a person in this room who don't know you stink.
If they know me, they know I don't care. Mark my words, boy. Defy me, and I'll see that you and every one of your friends locked up in the refuge for good. I know you're Mr. Tough Guy, but it's not nice to condemn that little crippled boy to conditions such as that. And what about your pal Davey and his baby brother? Ripped from their families and tossed to the rats. Would they ever be able to thank you enough? Time's running out, Jack, so what do you say? Cowboy or convict, I win either way. Your abject surrender is always the bottom line. Gentlemen, score against the cellar so we may reflect in solitude. Too bad you know job, Jack, but you did resign. Too bad you know family, but you can't have mine. Be glad you're alive, boy, I'd say that's the bottom line. Until those kids all believed you were right.
Lucky for them all, the one got away.
They may not be so lucky tonight.
We've been given discretion to handle you as we see fit, so behave.
But just in case, I polish in my favorite pair of brass knuckles.
You can sleep right here on this old print.
Newsies need our help today.
Newsies need our help today.
Tell them Brooklyn's on the way.
Tell them Brooklyn's on the way.
We're from
Brooklyn.
We are
Newsies.
We are Brooklyn
Newsies.
Boys, it's time to go slumming. Hey, Manhattan, the cavalry's coming. Have no fear.
We know we got your back from way back.
Brooklyn's here.
We'll get your payback with some payback.
We're the excited, loud and clear. Brooklyn's here.
Borrowa gave me birth, friendliest place on earth. Pay us a visit and see what we mean.
And what you do,
when you do, we'll kick you halfway. Now them soakers is in for a soaking. What a sad way to end a career. It's a joke, but if they think we're joking, loud and clear.
Manhattan's here, Flushing's here, Richmond's here, Westside's here.
So it's the Bronx!
Brooklyn's here.
Let's see what Mr. Pulitzer has to say to you now.
Yeah.
Hey, Davey, where's Jack?
Where's Jack?
Sorry, kid, no sign of him. Looks like you're doing a solo.
Jack!
Newsies of New York, look at what we've done. Tonight we have newsies from every pape in every neighborhood. Tonight we are making history.
Yeah!
Tonight we declare we're just as much a part of the newspaper as any editor or reporter.
Yeah!
We're tired of being treated like kids. And it's time we're treated as equals.
Yeah!
You want to be talked to like an adult? Then start acting like one. Don't just run your mouth. Make some sense.
And here's Jack!
Jack!
Right! Pulitzer raised the price of papes without so much as a word to us. Now that was a lousy thing to do.
Yeah!
So, we got mad and let them know we ain't gonna be pushed around.
Yeah!
So, we go on strike. And then what happens, huh? If Pulitzer lowers the prices, so he'll go back to work. And a few weeks after that, he'll hike the price back up again. And don't think he won't. And what do we do if he decides to raise the price again after that? Fellas, we gotta be realistic. We don't work, we don't get paid. How long can you go without making money? However long, believe me, Pulitzer can go longer. But I have spoken to Mr. Pulitzer, and he has given me his word. If we disband the union, he will not raise prices again for 2 years. He will even put it in writing.
No!
I say we take the deal. Go back to work knowing that our price is secure. All we have to do is vote no on the strike. Vote no!
No!
That was some speech you made.
How'd you get here?
Speck showed me.
Yeah, he said he could go through my stuff.
I saw them rolled up over there. I didn't know what they were. These drawings? They're drawings of the refuge, aren't they? Is that what it's really like? Three boys to a bed and vermin everywhere?
What, a little different from where you were raised?
Snyder told my father you were arrested stealing food and clothing. This is why, isn't it? You stole food to feed those boys. I don't understand. If you're willing to go to jail for those boys, why turn your back on them now?
No, I don't think you're anyone to talk about turning on folks.
I never turned on you or anyone else.
Oh, no, you just double-crossed to see your father. Your father!
My father has eyes on every corner of this city. He does not need me spying for him. And besides, I never lied. I just didn't tell you everything.
If you weren't a girl, you'd be trying to talk with a fist in your mouth.
I told you I worked for the Sun, and I did. I told you my professional name was Plumber, and it is. You never asked my real one.
I wouldn't think I had to unless I knew I was dealing with a backstabber.
If I was a boy, you'd be looking at me through one swollen eye.
Oh, don't let that stop you. Give me your best shot.
I need to know you didn't cave for the money.
I spoke the truth. You win a fight when you got the other fella down eating pavement. But you heard your father. No matter how many days we strike, he ain't giving up. I don't know what else we could do.
But I do.
Oh, come on.
Really, Jack? Really, only you can have a good idea? Or is it because I'm a girl?
Listen, I didn't say nothing.
This would be a good time to shut up. Being boss doesn't mean you have all the answers. Just the brains to recognize a good one when you hear it.
I'm listening.
Good for you. The strike was your idea. The rally was Davy's. And now my plan will take us to the finish line. Deal with it.
The children's crusade?
For the sake of all the children in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in New York, I beg you, join us. Those words, the strike stopped being about just the newsies. You challenged our whole generation to demand a place at the table.
The children's crusade.
Think, if we publish this, my words with one of your drawings, and if every worker under 21 read it and stayed home from work, or better yet, gathered at Newsy Square, a general citywide strike. Even my father couldn't ignore that.
Yeah, only one small problem. We got no way to print it.
Come on, there's gotta be at least one printing press he doesn't control.
Oh, no.
What?
I know where there's a printing press that no one would ever think we'd use.
Then why are we still standing here?
Wait. What's this about for you? And I don't mean the children's crusade. What's this about? Am I kidding myself, or is there something?
Of course there is.
Well, don't just say it like it happens every day.
Jack!
Listen, I'm not an idiot. You know, guys like me don't wind up with girls like you. And I don't want you promising nothing that you gotta take back later. But standing here tonight, looking at you, I'm scared tomorrow's gonna come and change everything. If there's a way I could grab a hold of something to make time stop, just so as I could keep looking at you.
You snuck up on me, Jack Kelly. I never even saw it coming.
For sure?
For sure. Till the moment I found you, I thought I knew what love was. Now I'm learning what is true, that love will do what it does. The world finds ways to sting you, and then one day decides to bring you something to believe in, for even the night. One night may be forever. That's alright, that's alright. And if you're gone tomorrow, what was ours still will be. I have something to believe in, now that I know you believe in me.
Just someone sweet passing by. An angel come to save me. Didn't even know she gave me something to believe in. For even today, one day maybe forever. But that's okay, that's okay.
You weren't going to Santa Fe?
And if you weren't an heiress, if your father wasn't after my head.
You're not really scared of my father.
No, but I am pretty scared of you.
Don't be. Look at the lights. You get those windows unlocked.
You got enough keys here for the entire building. What, has someone been picking Daddy's pockets?
The janitor has been working here since he was 8 and hasn't had a raise in 20 years. He's on our side 100%.
Are you bringing enough fellas to keep us covered?
We could hold a hoedown in here. No one would be the wiser.
Hey, good job.
Good to have you back.
Yeah, shut up.
Well, here she is, boys. Just think, while my father snores blissfully in his sleep, we'll be using his own printing press to take him down.
Remind me to stay on your good side.
Is this what they print the papes on?
I can see why they toss this old girl down in the cellar, but I think she'll do the job.
Jack, this is Darcy. He knows just about everything there is to know about printing.
You work for one of the papes?
My father owns the Trib.
Whoa!
He'll also be typesetting the article for us.
Ain't that something?
Well, in the words of the little one, can we skip the palaver and get down to business?
A little grease, and she'll be good as gold.
All right, here's the plan. If we print the papes, Race will let the fellas in and spread them to every working kid. After that,
it's up to them.
There's change coming once and for all. You make the front page, and menu is major news. Tomorrow they'll see what we are, and sure as a star, we ain't come this far.
The story we needed to write that's been kept out of sight but no more. In a few hours by dawn's early light we'll be ready to fight us a war. This time we're in to stay, talk about seizing the day.
Writing in ink and blood, it's the same either way. They're gonna damn well pay.
See all them bullets are snug in his bed. He don't care if we're dead or alive. 3-7 pillows are under his head while he's begging for bread to survive. Joe, you can stop counting sheep. We're gonna sing it asleep. Then when he snooze, we'll be lighting a fuse with a promise we're taking to keep.
Once and for all, I think all my demands will bleed up.
Bleed up.
Once and for all, we won't carry no bad. The dogs of
freedom. Finally, we've raised in the stakes. This time whatever it takes, this time the union awakes, once and for all.
In the words of Union Leader Jack Kelly, we will work with you, we will work for you. We will be treated and respected as members of your organizations. Riveting stuff, huh?
Get going. You've got a very important man to see.
Keep your fingers crossed.
For us too.
This
is for kids shining shoes on the street with no shoes on their feet every day. This is for guys sweating blood in the shops while the bosses and cops look away. I'm seeing kids standing tall, glaring and raring the brawl. Armies of guys who are sick of the lies, getting ready to rise to the call.
Sorry, but he'll have to call you back.
I'm sorry, he can't talk right now. He's gonna have to call you back.
I know, I'm sorry. He'll have to call you back.
Silence those phones.
The entire city is shut down. No one is working anywhere, and everyone is blaming you.
Everyone's calling. The publisher, the mayor, the manufacturer, and such language.
You can't just barge in.
How are we doing this morning, folks?
You're behind this? We had a deal.
And it came with a money-back guarantee. Oh, and thank you for your lessons on the power of the press.
Did you read this, boss? These kids had a pretty good paper. Very convincing.
No doubt written by my daughter.
Hey, I'd sign it before someone else grabs her up.
I demand to know who defied my ban against printing strike material.
We're your loyal employees. We would never take our business elsewhere.
The old printing press in the cellar.
I made you the offer of a lifetime. Anyone who does not act on their own self-interest is a fool.
And what's that make you? This all began because you wanted to sell more papers. And now your circulation is down 70%. Why didn't you just come talk to us?
Guys like Joe don't talk with nothings like us. But a very wise reporter once told me a real boss don't need the answers. Just the brains to snatch the right one up when he hears it.
Have a look out there, Mr. Pulitzer. In case you ain't figured it out yet, we got you surrounded.
New York is closed for business. Paralyzed. You can't get a paper or shoe shine. You can't ride an elevator across the Brooklyn Bridge. You can't even leave your own building. So, what's your next move?
Mr. Pulitzer, The mayor is here, along with your daughter, and, oh, you're not gonna believe who else.
Mr. Pulitzer, I believe you know the governor.
Governor Roosevelt?
Joseph, 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 what have you done now?
I'm certain when you hear my explanation.
Well, thanks to Miss Metalarkin bringing your daughter to my office, I believe I have a firm grasp on the situation. Graphic illustrations included. Bully is the term that I usually use for approval. But in your case, I simply mean bully. And is this the boy of whom you spoke? Hello, son. I'm told we shared a carriage ride together.
Pleasure's mine, Mr. Governor.
Well, Joe, don't just stand there and leave those children out there. Give them the good news.
What good news?
That you've come to your senses and rolled back prices. That is, of course, unless you want to invite a full state Senate investigation into your employment practices.
You wouldn't dare.
Huh. After the pressures you wielded to keep me from office, I do it with a smile. Come along, Joseph. The only thing worse than a hard heart is a soft head. And think of the happiness you'll bring the children. He doesn't do happiness, does he?
Mr. Kelly, if I may speak to you alone.
Keep your eyes on the stars and your feet on the ground. You can do this.
I cannot put the price of the paper to back where it was. I'm sorry. I can't. There's other considerations.
You know, it's fine. You need to save face in front of all these folks. I'm young. I ain't stupid.
Thank you for understanding.
But I got constituents with a legitimate gripe.
What if I lower the raise by half and get the others to do the same? It's a compromise we can all live with.
But you eat our losses. From now on, any papers we don't sell, you buy back. Full price.
Now that was never on the table. What's to stop the newsy from taking hundreds of papers they can't sell? My costs will explode.
No newsy is going to break his back hauling around papers he can't sell. But if they could take a few more with no risk, they might sell them, and your circulation would begin to grow. It's a compromise we can all live with.
That's not a bad head you got on your shoulders.
Deal?
That's disgusting.
Just the price of doing business.
Aside and invite the young to share the day. You have all laid claim to our world, and I believe the future in your hands will be bright and prosperous. Son, your drawings have brought another matter to bear. Officers, if you please.
Jack, look at it, it's crunchy.
Hey, fellas, did you miss me?
Of course you did.
And I brought you a gift straight from the refuge. Bring him in, fellas.
It's Snyder the Spider.
Looking tough no more now, is he?
Jack, your drawings have made an eloquent argument to shut down the refuge. Be assured that any abuses or Mr. Schneider's abuses will be fully investigated. Officer, take him away.
Your Highness, if I may do the honors.
You've got to be kidding me.
And you'll be laughing all the way back to the pen, little man.
Thank you, Governor.
You know, I wonder if one of your own drawings could shut down something such as the refuge. I wonder what a daily political cartoon could do to shine some light on the back rooms of our government.
Don't sweat it, Gov. Now, with the strike settled, I should probably be hitting the road anyways.
Don't you ever get tired of singing that same old tune? What Santa Fe got the New York date? A bunch of big old get-a-munchies?
Better yet, what's New York got that Santa Fe ain't?
New York's got us, and we's a family.
Didn't I hear something about the strike being settled?
Thanks for the newsies. Line up.
Come, Governor, let's get brunch.
Well, go on. You have a union to run. And besides, didn't someone just offer you a pretty interesting job?
Me? Work for your father?
You already work for my father.
Oh, yeah.
And you've got one more ace up your sleeve.
And what would that be?
Me. Wherever you go, I'll be there right by your side.
For sure?
For sure.
Don't take much to be a dreamer. All you do is close your eyes. But some made-up world is all you ever see. Now my eyes is finally open, and my dreams, they's average-sized. But they don't much matter if you ain't with me.
Jack, in or out?
We'll all be out there carrying the banner man to man. We're always out there soaking every sucker that we can. Here's a headline, Newsies on a mission, kill the competition. Sell the next edition, we'll be out there carrying the banner. See us out there carrying the banner, always out there carrying the banner. Look at me, I'm the king of New York. Suddenly, I'm respectable, stare right at your lousy with stature. Glory be, I'm the king of New York.
can they get us out? Take away our vote!
More light outside.